All right. Back by popular demand. The King Firehawk podcast world, podcast/video/everything you want to know. Yeah, King Firehawk's podcast world. And we did a top 10 of a great YouTube video that I came across called The Hats, Sports Hats You Should Never Wear in Los Angeles. And I got such a kick out of that. I only did the 10 because you know my feeling on the top 20. Top 10 is it, baby. And that's usually 7 through 10 is debatable with 11 through 13. That's why people make the 20. They don't want to leave out something, you know, here and there. That's why a top 5 list is the best you can do, according to good old King Firehawk here. Because that's like the best of the best. That's the one part of the list you're completely sure of. But I'm going to do what we call the jobber side of the top 20. 20 to 11. Because you made it happen out there. You tweeted and got back and said, hey, King Firehawk, I know that you picked, and you can go download the show and listen, the Hartford Yard Goats would be our gang hat. Go check out the Hartford Yard Goats hat there. It's very intimidating. It's a picture of a billy goat with a bat in its mouth. Just imagine a billy goat with a bat in its mouth clobbering you. And blood all over the place, ECW style. Yeah, man. That'd be intimidating, right? Show up in LA, brand new. We're the Hartford Yard Goats gang, yo. And we're taking your turf, baby. Anyhow, let's find out 20 to 11. If you're a nice family from Wichita, Kansas, who want a trip to LA and you want to go to Disney and all this other cool stuff, walk on the stars, Hollywood Hall of Fame, don't best be wearing this hat or a drive-by might occur on you, or a gang member may run up to you and ask you to hide some evidence, or you know, come turn out somebody because they need the day off and you got to work a corner. So, you know, that could happen if you're wearing one of these hats. Let's find out which hats they are.
Number 20, Pittsburgh Pirates baseball cap. A favorite among Mexican Americans, the golden Pittsburgh Pirates insignia is often...
Well, I do have a pirate hat because I love the old school Tuckative and Willie Stargell hats. The Premier Flats gang wear the Pittsburgh Pirates hat. And that's why this is the jobber side. The Pirates do nothing but lose. I'm sure this gang loses all the time. That's why they're rated number 20.
Pirates fan or simply like the way the hat looks, consider taking this headpiece off if you're visiting the area. Number 19. Michigan Wolverines football.
Screw Michigan.
Perhaps as a reference to the gang's initials, the M on the Wolverines football caps has been adopted by members of the Main Street Mafia Crips.
Sounds like a wrestling gang. But they're wearing Michigan Wolverine hats. Oh, there's a lot of you people that are going to be in trouble visiting Los Angeles because Michigan seems like a nice Midwestern hat to a college to root for. Lots of fans. Uh-oh. Better consider taking that off. Put on a Notre Dame hat. You'll be good.
Remember to run for cover. Number 18. St. Louis Cardinals baseball cap. It might be the red color or the letters on the insignia, but this hat from Missouri is often used by members of both the Black Peastone Bloods and the Bloodstone Villains.
Wow. Two gangs. They must be fighting over this stuff themselves. I do have a Cardinals hat and actually wore it the other day when I was out and about. And that's funny. You'd be in trouble if you're going to LA in a Cardinals hat. Oh, you Ozzie Smith fans, be aware.
Number 17. San Francisco 49ers football hat. The black,
well, screw the 49ers to begin with.
For the San Francisco 49ers is often associated with the family Swan Bloods.
The family Swan Bloods will think if you're wearing a 49ers gear, it's not because you fell in love with Joe Montana and Dwight Clark in the 1980s. It's because you're part of the family Swan gang.
As the Crips and the Bloods settle their differences on the streets.
Well, I don't have any 49ers. Oh, I do have a Tim Rattay 49ers jersey and a visor hat. because I like correcting scrub quarterbacks Boston when their jerseys go on sale.
Considering the Red Sox huge popularity among baseball fans, the common man might struggle to link the team's crest to any kind of criminal activity. Nevertheless,
oh, stupid YouTube commercial. How dare they? But the Boston Red Sox have a gang affiliate that wears their damn hat in L.A.
Oh, no.
Well, I would never be caught dead wearing a Boston Red Sox gear of any kind. Never owned it, never will. Although I must admit, I was a big Carlton Fisk fan.
Both members of the Brims and a variety of
the
other
L.A. Brims gang.
As such,
wearing a Boston Red Sox hat.
In Los Angeles. This is especially true if they're exploring the westernmost parts of
I'm
the
sure there's a lot of Boston Red Sox fans that roll through L.A., so watch
North
out.
North Carolina Tar Heels basketball.
Ah, the Tar Heels.
With the light blue lettering and the intricate designs, gadgets from the North Carolina Tar Heels are an obvious choice for any Crip-related clique. Among them, members of the Rollin' 90s Neighborhood
the
Crips.
The Rollin' 90s Neighborhood Crips. Love the North Carolina Tar Heels. Well, that is a cool hat. And the Air Jordans that come out, the white leather, patent leather, blue baby blues are awesome. And I'm sure there's probably a lot of Carolina fans rolling through L.A., so watch out, man. They're going to want you to come help them cause violence, apparently.
Number 14. Florida Marlins baseball cap.
Florida Marlins.
Another set of primarily blue accessories. Items from the Florida Marlins baseball team are extremely popular among members of the Crips. More specifically,
the Crips love their Florida Marlins.
The Rollin' 50s neighborhood often use these
the Rollin' 50s neighborhood Crips.
The item choice is likely related
it's
to the
great because logo, they love the gear, yet the Florida Marlins can't draw shit in their own stadium among fans. So maybe they should move and become a gang in Florida and fill the stadium.
Minnesota Twins baseball
team. Oh, no, the Twins.
The trend we saw with the last two entries, the blue, white, and red T logo of the Minnesota Twins,
the North Midwest,
adopted as the standard for a Crips gang. The caps remain particularly popular among criminals affiliated with the Rollin' 30 Crips.
The Rollin' 30 Crips have adopted the Midwestern Northern Twin Cities Twins hat, which I have because it's badass. They must really love Harmon Killebrew.
Wearing a Minnesota Twins cap anywhere in California is an extremely ill-advised fashion choice.
I just think these people just want to have a nice, happy days like midlife. Oh, no.
The M in Milwaukee has apparently
the Milwaukee Brewers? What's with this Midwest,
yeah, the Blue Brewers hats have long been worn thirst. By members of the Rollin' 40s Crips.
The Rollin' 40s, another gang that wants to be a wholesome Midwestern
LA,
family, I guess.
Are known for the violence
the Milwaukee Brewers, again, you can't
as
wear their hat walking around.
Paraphernalia.
You say something bad about Robin Yount, you're going to get knifed. Oh, this is great. I love this nonsense.
Number 11. Chicago Bulls basketball hat.
The Bulls.
It is
the
almost
Bulls.
Obvious that the logo of the Chicago Bulls would have been adopted by a Bloods gang. In fact, these hats are the favorite headgear of several cliques in the Alliance, whose members often wear them because of the color. Alongside the red shirts and the baggy pants, the Chicago Bulls basketball hats clearly signal a gangbanger's affiliation. You should tread lightly around these people and avoid them whenever you can.
The Alliance. So what they're saying is all gangs, when they want to just step out and not have a violent day, there's an alliance, I guess, where you can take off your Milwaukee Brewer hat that day, let's say, or your Los Angeles Raiders hat, and you can put on a Chicago Bulls hat. Now, let's be real. Nowadays, I don't see as much Bulls swag around in my journeys through life because all the front runners are gone because Jordan's not there anymore. But there's still Air Jordans. People love to match up the gear. I don't have a Chicago Bulls hat. I got Air Jordans. But I wonder, by the way, if they made the sneakers you shouldn't wear either. I gotta research this more. This is fascinating to me. But there's a lot of Chicago Bulls fans that if you are taking a family trip to L.A. and got a Bulls hat on, you know, it's not like you're on vacation from your gang in an alliance. And today's the day where we all going to dress up in our Bulls gear because we're all gang members of it's like the All-Star game. uniform for gang members. I gotta tell you, folks, it's just hilarious that this is a thing, right? Of everything going on, you know, you're going to Los Angeles, you want to go see the Jimmy Kimmel show, you want to go find, Adam Sandler's house, you want to take a drive on the Pacific Coast Highway, go to the Valley to have a hot dog that's way overrated at Pink's, take it all in, you know, all the things, the tourist things to do in L.A., and you're wearing, like, the wrong hat, and you're going to get hassled, according to this list. And it's funny, because I'm thinking back now. Well, a long time ago, in the 90s, I did go to L.A., because I got some family that ended up moving north of L.A. out there. And I had an old-school Pirates jersey on, and the old-school yellow with the P, 19, late 60s Pirates hat, like the Roberto Clemente style hat. And I have a picture somewhere playing wiffle ball. And I'm wearing my retro Air Barkley Olympic sneakers. My Umbro, was it? Made those soccer shorts. And my Pittsburgh Pirates jersey and hat and playing wiffle ball. Looking like Greg Luzinski. Getting ready to hit the King Firehawk, ready to hit a home run and go have a bunch of hot dogs. And it's so funny that, you know, maybe people looked out the window that day and go, oh, the West Coast Firehawks, it looks like they got a family member in and they're in a gang. Hurry, lock the door. He's got a Pirates gear on. That means he's part of blah, blah, blah gang, whatever they said. I find that funny as hell. Anyhow, all right, I'm King Firehawk. This was the jobber side of the top 20 list. 20 through 11 of hats you should never wear when venturing out to Los Angeles, baby. And you can tweet us at FirehawkNJOU812 or check us out on YouTube for our videos, which is King Firehawk's Podcast World. We are on iTunes, King Firehawk's Podcast World, as well as Spreaker and Spotify. And that's all for today. Catch you when I catch you. All right, all right, all right. Cause nobody can do it like Mixmaster can. Come on now. I got the T-double-O style. And here we go again because it's been a while. Do me a favor, don't touch that dial. I rock from Manhattan to the Miracle Mile. My name is Rocky and I'm a lady's choice. You wanna get next to me, my Rolls Royce. You'll get the man, I hear my golden voice. So when it's time to roar, you come know on, I get noise. This is cruising like a fanboy who wanna claim. You'll tweak your ass across the crossfade. So watch your back when it takes the stage. I'm gonna send you all on a naked rampage. We're just three MCs and one DJ. Sweet and sour like a tangerine, fresh like a box of the Krispy Kreme. Kenny Rogers did it, so get ready to with the smash the mic. Who's up the scratch routine? He's always up in it and in the know. No, we're breaking down, going toe to toe. The bass is coming from down below, and Norton is chilling with Mario. And when my name is Ad Rock, I'm a Scorpio. And don't ask me, cause I just don't know. I'm known to mobbing and I'm known to glow. But don't get mad when we got to go. We're just three MCs and one DJ. Take care of you.